Well, May is known for springtime weather and flowers, but it's also a great month for stargazing opportunities. Our good buddy Jason Kendall, astronomer, is here to give us a preview for what to look out for this month and a few tips on the tools you need to view the stars. Jason, thanks. It's good to see you again.
Good to be here. Good to be back.
All right. So Saturn is a big star to look at.
We're starting the summer of Saturn, starting about the end of the month. Actually, I was out this morning watching Saturn rise. It's right next to the moon. And tomorrow night, Saturn and the moon will be right next to each other in the sky. Saturn rises in the east all throughout the summer, and it's going to be in what's called opposition, meaning that Saturn is across the sky from the sun. Okay. So as the sun sets, Saturn rises.
Well, and you say it's good to see Saturn with a telescope.
Absolutely.
You brought some great entry-level telescopes.
I sure did. So what I've got here is the first one is this is the Galileo scope, a small 2-inch refractor that was made for the International Year of Astronomy in 2009. These were distributed all over the world, and hundreds of thousands were given to third world countries, and lots of people have seen the stars through this one.
How much?
It's about $30, and you can get them at galileoscope.org.
Okay, and you need a tripod?
Probably. Yeah, you got to get a tripod with this.
Okay, this looks a little more substantial.
Well, I brought this from my university, from William Patterson. I got a bunch of these for my students. And this is just a 6-inch Dobsonian telescope. It's got a mirror at the bottom, a little finder scope, eyepiece. You can look through it, point at the sky, and check out what's up in the sky.
And about how much for this?
Well, these are about $300 to $400, and some go up to about $700.
Okay, and then this next one?
Well, this is kind of my DIY sort of put-together thing. I actually used this particular telescope. I got what's called a Schmidt-Cassegrain telescope, another reflector. It's the same size as this one, but the focal length a lot shorter. Mm-hmm. You look through here, and this mount is made by an artisan by the name Tom Peter.
Well, that's very cool. Jason, thanks so much.